you have a different line on this. So I'm curious, given your concern about the consequences of the illicit trade, how you think about the question of keeping it illicit or beginning to open that up a little bit. So at least what is happening is under the law, you can regulate it, you can watch it, you can keep some control over it.
So this one's a tough one for me because my views are not, do not lie, exactly line up with my own state, and it's something that I am struggling with. I think, look, there's, when it comes to legalization of marijuana, if that is something that society has decided that we want to do, fine. I think we got to be really careful about what exactly that means and how we do it. So we decriminalized it when I was in the court system, when I was trying cases or shortly thereafter, if I remember the years right, in Massachusetts. When we decriminalized it, it actually had a pretty big consequence for the way that Massachusetts the prosecutors went about trying cases in terms of, because an odor of marijuana was, at least initially, because marijuana was an illegal substance, if you smelled it in a car, you could search a car. When it became decriminalized, you couldn't do that. So that was the way that we had the base case that prosecutors used to search cars that undercovered contraband, guns, knives, a whole bunch of other stuff. All of that got thrown out the window. That's not to say that's right or wrong, but that is to say when that went through a public referendum, which is how that law was passed, I don't think anybody had much thought to, you're actually going to change one of the foundational principles for law enforcement that we use in our court system. There is no reliable, at least in Massachusetts, roadside test to test to see whether somebody's under the influence of marijuana. Presumably, with more widespread usage of marijuana, that is at least a threat that's going to go up. I think it's worth us understanding, well, do we have the tools that are necessary in order to keep the communities safe as we try to actually go through and make this a substance that is far more widespread? It's something that while there's the casual marijuana user isn't something that I'm over, that I have a whole lot of concerns about. There is evidence and data about obviously youth, teens, adolescents getting access to marijuana and what that can do. And as we've talked about before, one of my main focuses in Congress is on mental behavioral health and addiction. And there's a number of voices in that community that do pose, I think, serious questions about some of the either the decriminalization or legalization efforts there. And I think we just need to be careful about that.